Is spray foam insulation flammable? Let's talk about it. Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to be addressing the topic, is spray foam insulation flammable? So please make sure you stay all the way to the end of this video because we might just burn this place down. Before we get into that, please go below, hit that like button for us, but only if you're as hot as me. So if you're asking the question, is spray foam insulation flammable, we would have to say no, because it is absolutely not easy to ignite, it's not easy to catch on fire in any sort of way. And of course I'm referring to the products that we use in-house that are class 1 rated. We'll get more into that in just a minute. Right now I want to start talking about combustion temperatures, and this is really what we have to look at. So if we're looking at spray foam insulation, and we ask, you know, is it flammable? What are the concerns that come into play? Well, keep in mind, first, as a rule of thumb, the products that we use, it will ignite at around 800 degrees. Now, of course, that's Fahrenheit. Now, that's a high number, especially if we take in consideration that the wood that we build our houses with will ignite at 500 degrees. Now, at that point, again, once you reach 800 degrees, the entire wall structure is on fire. The drywall, which can really reach combustion temperatures around 450, carpeting is starting to melt, and that can be considered combustion as well. Everything else in the house is already on fire by the time you get to 800 degree mark, where the foam would be considered combustible. So just something to keep in mind when you're looking at the building as a whole. There's so many other things going on inside that wall assembly, in the attic space, in the crawl space. The foam insulation that you're looking at specifically right now is not anywhere near the top of the list of concerns. Now, I mentioned that we only use spray foam products that are class 1 fire rated. Now, what makes up that rating? It's really two things that we're concerned about, and this is also the things that your building inspectors, that your code officials will be concerned about as well. That is the flame spread index and the smoke development rating. Now, both of these have to be below a certain number to achieve or earn a class 1 rating. We will only ever use class 1 rated products because of that safety factor. Now, again, those two factors that we really look at, the flame spread index and smoke development, if we think about that really simply, how fast will actual flames spread and can grow to reach other building materials to spread on itself? And smoke development, how much smoke will this material create while it's being burned or charred? Those are the two key components that make up that class rating. And again, you always want to look for that class 1 material. So the last point that I want to leave you with is that yes, we are always going to be concerned about having a house fire. That's why we buy smoke detectors. That's why we have fire extinguishers throughout our house. We are always going to be concerned about that as homeowners. Now, if you're looking at spray foam and that being a concern for you, again, that's why we push the class 1 rating, why that's so important for you to be looking for when you're shopping for insulation. It just goes to show you that all the technology, the improvements in foam insulation, really make it to where that should not be a concern for you in regards to a potential house fire. Now, to really drive home this point, let's check out some footage of what spray foam acts like when it's in contact with fire. If you want to learn more about if spray foam insulation is flammable, check out the link below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and ring that bell to see all of our notifications.